Water flames tear apart a yacht in Daytona Beach. Our crews arrived just in time to capture the intense fire and thick cloud of smoke. West News' Kendra A-Strike is live at the Sunset Harbor Yacht Club. And Kendra, this was really not an easy task for these firefighters.
That's right, Craig. It was a tough battle for so many reasons. First, there was a delay in reporting the fire. Then fire crews had to drag their hoses down the docks to get to the fire. Once on board, they had to dodge exploding bullets. You can see there's not much left of the multi-million dollar yacht.
That guy's having a bad day.
A bad start indeed to Patrick Armstrong's Saturday. Firefighters say he had been taking a shower around 7:20 this morning on his 71-foot yacht when bang.
He heard a loud explosion, came out of the shower and noticed fire in the closet area of his boat.
Crews say Armstrong unsuccessfully battled the flames on his own, trying to save the $3 million plus Princess Lauren for some time before calling 911.
So the delay kind of hurt our efforts to extinguish the fire earlier.
Black smoke filled the sky and could be seen for miles.
I saw the smoke from over on the beach and I thought, what the heck's going on?
Onlookers watched from the bridge and down at the yacht club. Firefighters struggled to get water out to the dock and burning boat, then battled excessive heat and smoke as they made their way on board. A treacherous firefight became even more dangerous. The boat began to tip and bullets from Armstrong's handgun started flying.
Those ammunitions began to fire off with the heat, and which was another reason for us having to evacuate.
It took 7 hours for crews to get the fire under control from the outside. The owner met with fire investigators, too distraught to talk about this huge loss. Other boating enthusiasts feel his pain.
I had thought about buying a boat for myself, but might want to rethink that, maybe just rent.
Right now, firefighters are still putting out hot spots. The yacht is touching the bottom, so won't sink any further. There is up to 1,000 gallons of fuel on board that has started to leak. Crews hope to contain it with barriers and foam. The fire marshal will be back out here in the next couple of days trying to figure out how this boat place began. Live in Daytona Beach in Volusia County, Kendra A-Strike.